Hi, this is the first presentation in the finite state machines with data path module, where we will consider introductory concepts related to this class of circuits. At the end of this presentation, I hope that you will be able to explain what is the distinctive feature of finite state machines with data path, and also to be able to explain how the data path plus control path architecture can be adapted to represent a binary multiplier and a very simple CPU. This presentation comprises three parts, starting with the distinctive feature of this type of circuits, followed by the two examples that have just been referred. So, what is a finite state machine with data path? An FSMD is one level of complexity above a finite state machine. Actually, a finite state machine is one of the building blocks for creating an FSMD, since it controls the blocks that make up the data path. It should also be said that FSMDs are widely used in the implementation of systems described at register transfer level, which is intrinsic to the fact that FSMDs are more complex than finite state machines. This slide shows a block diagram representing the architecture of an FSMD. Notice the control path at the bottom, made up of a finite state machine and several data units comprised in the data path represented on top. Data units can be any type of combinational or sequential circuits, including other finite state machines. It is also important to notice that the data path and the control path exchange information through the inputs and outputs shown. The data units provide information about the operations taking place in the data path, and the control path provides commands determining what operations should be performed. Let's consider the first example, a binary multiplier. Binary multiplication can be carried out by a fully combinational block, as you may recall from the 74181 ALU. That will be the fastest solution, but also the costliest, since it requires a large number of parallel resources. An alternative solution, when time is not a problem, is to perform multiplication by adding one of the operands to itself as many times as indicated by the other operand. In this case, we will just need another and a counter plus some additional registers to hold the cumulative sum and the output result. Multiplication by successive addition is actually a good example to illustrate an FSMD application where the data path comprises the adder, the counter, and the data registers. This slide shows the organization of the data path, and it matches very well the general block diagram that was presented earlier. The second example is a minimal CPU. The stored program computer concept dates back to the 1940s when the first such machines were built. In this type of architecture, the instructions and data are fetched from memory by a central processing unit or CPU. Program execution takes place by repeating a sequence of operations that include the following steps. The CPU fetches an instruction code from memory and decodes the corresponding operation. It then fetches data if needed. The operation is performed. And finally, the result is stored back into memory if needed. This means that a CPU must comprise an instruction register to hold the instruction code, a program counter to generate the memory addresses, at least one data register to perform an operation, and finally, an instruction decoder and execution control unit. This is also a minimal CPU architecture because if you remove any one of the blocks, it won't work anymore. If you put them together, as shown in this slide, you again have a perfect match to the general block diagram representing an FSMD. The instruction decoder and execution control unit is in fact a finite state machine that works as the control path, and the remaining blocks make up the data path. This second example closes the introductory presentation to finite state machines with data path. Thanks for your attention.